Hello, hello, hello! I'm back playing another game from Game Jolt, and this one is Unforgiving, a Northern Hem. Now, I actually installed this a couple of days ago, and I didn't get around to playing it, but because it was such a dark, stormy, and thunderous night here in New York, I thought, what better time to play a game that is also dark and ominous. Now, I've said before that I don't play a lot of indie horror games on my channel, mainly because they usually don't do it for me, but this one seemed really promising. I haven't watched any gameplay footage, so I'm not exactly sure what kind of game this is. I just know that it's first person, and it seems like it's going to be atmospheric. It seems really promising. So, let's jump into it. Start game! Okay. Whoa. All right, am I drowning? Am I supposed to be doing something about this? What's going on? Click, click, click. Anything supposed to happen here? Oh, okay. Oh. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right. Oh, this looks good. Wiggle, wiggle. Oh, this looks really good. What is it? Okay. Oh, all right. Mouse to look around. Oh, nice. Okay. I just dropped a cup and that scared the shit out of me. So that is a preview of what this game is going to be. I'm already scaring myself in real life. I like the texture on this. This is good. All right. Must find help. Yeah, it's fucking dark out there, though. What is it? Ooh! Sky! Alright. Alright, let's go. So, I like it so far. I like the sound design. I mean, I'm in a forest. I don't like that. But we're just gonna go. You know, this is what you would do in real life. You know what? You just follow the river. Follow the river. So, I'm just gonna go. Can I run? Yeah. Okay, good. Shift to run. What the f... You bug. You know, all this land for that bug to traverse and it needed to go right in my ear. That's fine. I don't dictate nature. Let's go. What's over here? What's going on? To get some growths coming off of this. Hello, mushroom. Can I eat you and go crazy? No? Okay. I keep going. I really like this. I like the sound design on this a lot. And I like the way this starts. You know, a lot of these games, they do start with that, oh, I woke up and now I don't know where I am. But then they don't do it right after that point. And this is doing it right. Oh, light, light. This is doing it right by giving me light. Okay, wait. Oh, I thought I heard something. Okay. You know, I don't know if you've ever gone, like, camping or anything like that. It was a house. Ever gone camping and such. But if you have, if you've been in absolute total darkness and then you see, like, a campfire light in the distance, that shit is harrowing. You know, if you've never experienced it, you would think that light is supposed to, you know, be comforting, especially in the dark. But it's not. When you're walking around in pitch black in the woods and you see a little flicker in the distance and you think in your mind, oh, that has to be another human being, there's also this part of you that's like, but wait. And you start to get this chill up your spine. And the point being, you know, camping is horrible. All right. Eater interact. Oh, mashas. Good, good, good. Ugh, my arm. Can we get a burger after this? I'm concerned about you. Press left mouse button to light the match. Got it. I like that I have to do everything so exaggeratedly, but you know what? I like the animation here. I like that it's very smooth. Why do I need to press the mouse button to drop it? I guess that's so it doesn't burn my hand. Is it going to burn down? Let me see. Okay, yeah. All right, so let's just drop it. I don't need it right now. I'm gonna assume those are unlimited. Yeah, that NC. Holy shit, and peanut butter jelly. What the f? Okay. Alright. So we just won't go that way then. Okay. All right. Anyway, fine. That's fine. You know, that happens sometimes. Let's just go this way. What? The fuck was that squeaky squonk? Was that a gate? It sounded... Oh, wait, no, I see light. Okay. Yeah, who to you two? Fucking owls. I hate owls. Or whatever that other thing is. Isn't there another thing that sounds like owls? It's like a different type of bird, but it has a similar call. This is not Nat Geo. I don't know why. That's what I'm concerned about. What? Why does it sound like this is... This is swinging, but I see no motion. That makes no sense. Why do I need to open that? Do I need to, or is it just... The fuck? All right, I'm gonna assume that... What is making that noise? I don't like that. I don't like Squeaky McGee in the night. Oh, I see another light over there. Wait, should I go right or should I go left? I don't know. There's a track, though. I'm gonna go left. I'm gonna go this way. Let's get a light going. I'm going to assume that because those lanterns are there and you can interact with them, that maybe there will be lanterns that I can light. What is that? I don't know why I hear drums. I'm just going to keep walking. Okay, yeah. No. You know what? When the music escalates, I don't like the swells. I don't like the swelly swell. No. Go. Just follow the track to where it's at. I don't know why I'm running. I just don't like when the music escalates. I think, am I good? All right, well, this is an awfully suspicious place for these tracks to lead into a fucking cave. Ooh, let me put that out before I burn myself. Holy shit, it's dark. Okay. All right, music, I got it. All right, you pushed me forward. What the fuck is... I thought I heard something near me. Holy precious Jesus of the clouds. All right. What the hell kind of track would lead into this kind of place? What is in here? Fucking A. Okay, it's a mine. I got it. Maybe I should let that match burn down. Maybe I'll do something about that manicure. You know what I'm saying? Look at that shit. I gotta fix my nails. Yep. Just go on here doing shit I would never do in real life. That's fine. Let's just crawl. Let's just crawl in here. That's weird. Where would that other track have led? Because it stopped and then there's one here. That doesn't make any sense. Who designed this? Oh, let's just cut this off. I don't like this. Be a little quicker about it. Be a little quicker about getting that lit, please. Jesus. Thank you. What? I like the developer's choice to, make it very quiet once you transition into here. But also, I hate it because it's creepy. What is that? What the fuck? What? The fuck is this? What? I heard scuttling skittery noises, and I don't like it. What is this? Give me this. Oh! What is this? Like some ancient version of Pog? Or whatever the hell that game is? What is that game that has slammers? I don't know. The thing where you flip the things. What the hell? Excuse me? Excuse me! What the fuck? Yeah, and there was nowhere it could have gone. Okay, I don't... You know what? No. I'm not even gonna say anything about it. You know what? There's nothing wrong with being naked. That's why... Oh, shit. Oh, fucking... Okay, light it back up. Light it back up. Light it up, bitch, please. Please. Oh, God. Did it always take three strikes? Jesus. It's fine. You know, it's fine. Little nudity never killed anyone. Okay. Maybe that did. What is this? What is this? Glasses and blood. All right. That makes me feel much better about my situation. More blood. Even more secure, I feel. What was that? Is that a phone? What the fuck? That's the scariest thing of all. Analog. You know. For anyone who had dial-up. You people know what I'm talking about. Oh god. Oh shit. Alright, come on. No. What? What? Why the violin? Did I miss something? What happened? What the fuck? I'm just gonna fucking go. I'm just gonna go. Cause I don't know what's happening. Just go. I kind of want to explore, but I also don't want to leave the tracks. The tracks making me feel safe. It's making me feel whole. I hear you, and I refuse to acknowledge you. I am just a happy person walking through a perfectly safe, secure, and warm mine. And I don't want to hear your bullshit. What's going on? I'm just going to walk. This is fucking creepy. I like the attention to sound. Oh my god, can you please? Alright, let me just put it out right now. Oh my god. Light it, light it, light it, light it, light it. Every time I'm gonna light it, I feel like there's gonna be something just fucking standing there. And I love that. This is promising already. This is better already than... Like, why the musy? Why the musy music? What is going on? Okay, I'm gonna run. What the f- Hi? Hello? No, I hear feet. What are you doing? What's happening? Click, click, click. Oh, ew! Hello? Did I- Oh, fuck. Oh, okay, bye. What the fuck? You bit me, bitch? Okay, yeah. Dig in it with your pinky, because that's gonna help. Just dig into the wound with your disgusting fingernail to test the blood. What are you doing? Like, what was the point of that? The fuck was that? Okay. Oh, and then there's this. Alright. Wait, am I outside? I'm curious to know what that was. Was that what we looked like? I believe so, brother. Who's talking? The fuck is talking? What the fuck? Oh, shit! Oh, it's trees. Oh, god. I don't know what I thought that was. I also should not feel better about the fact that they're trees because they have faces. Oh, fuck. Fuck. Come on, light. Light, please. Come on. Okay. Woo. All right. Oh, okay. Yeah. Look at the tree titty, I guess, is what I'm going to do. Oh. That's a bite mark. So is this what happens then? Yeah. Ew. Is that progressing? Oh, hold Q to check arm. Thank you for allowing me to do that. Yep, just as I suspected. I'm fucked up. Hello? Were you talking to me? What is that coming out of your eyes? Is that sap? I'm sorry. You look like you've been through something. Let's go forward. You know what? It's fine. All of this is fine. I hear rocks. I'm just not even gonna. I want to explore, but oh. Ooh. Storm still. Den stora ser dåligt. Okay. Is the large one in here? Is that you giving me future advice or now advice? I would really like to know. What? Okay, go back. Go back. Back on, please. Thank you. Can I look at your face? Oh, hi, you're a lady. Oh, you look... oh, You let yourself go. Okay, you know what? Let's just go. Let's just go.
Hans fail.
His fault, Walter. He who lived here, he Hans who let them in, he who started everything. All right, well, whoever he is, he's a dick if he's responsible for this shit, because I need to know. Can I check it again? Can I keep look? Oh, yeah. Okay, that's progressive. I feel like that's telling me that this is urgent. Did I? Oh, God. So let's move forward. I like that a lot. I like the fact. What? Don't hurt. Is that you? You know what? Let me get up to your fucking face. Let me tell you something. I will continue when I have the light because I'm too scared to talk in the dark. Okay, as I was saying, if your mother is the one who bit me, you damn right I'm gonna hurt that bitch, all right? I'm just letting you know. Don't get in my face. Do you see this shit? Do you see this? Look at that shit. That's what your mom did. You tell me not to hurt her? No, friend. That is not how things go in my universe. That is not the book that I wrote. You worry about yourself. All right, let's go. Okay, nothing. Just, oh, hi. Oh, God, that whispering is so creepy. What is that? Is that just graphical shit? Why is, like, the wall going crazy? Hi. Hello? Oh, look at you in your little coconut-looking thing. Do you mind if I just, if I just squeeze through here, you mind if I just get in a little? I can't get my arm there. Okay. I'm gonna need you to hold E. What am I doing? Oh no! Oh no! Oh God! Wait! Oh no! Oh shit! Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh no! 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 Okay, I know what I have to do, and I'm sorry. I don't want to do it, but like. But this concerns me. I feel like that is a matter of time. I'm sorry, but I just need, am I doing it? Oh God. Okay. Well, I don't feel. Okay, you know what? Things need to be done. I like this. I like the burning embers. That's a nice touch. All right, so I just murdered something, potentially? Let's just squeeze on through here. Just feel the rock. Just feel it up like titties and ass. Just feel it. Just squeeze all over the rock and get through. All right, that was a pretty long shimmy sham. Let's get light going, please. Please act like this is an emergency. Please act with some immediacy here when you light these matches, okay? Alright, let's just go. Let's just go. Everything's fine, you know? I really do like, though, that you can actually actively look at the progress of this by hitting Q. Because a lot of games will have that just be a sort of a scripted event and you can't actually control it yourself. And I feel like being able to control it yourself is another thing that adds to the sense of urgency in this game, and that's really good for pacing. What the fuck am I hearing? Excuse me? That's what I thought. Well, yeah, I'm just gonna run. I'm gonna run. So, I don't know, I'm assuming I'm trying to get to that house that was across. This is another thing I like, too, is the I swear if something comes and jumps out at me while I'm out here in the damn dark. Holy cannolis. Thank you. Wow. As I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted by terror, you know, there are a lot of games that have the... What? Whoa. Lights out. Holy shit. I don't know why I'm being quiet as if me talking is going to matter. But, all right, yeah, go off in the distance. Go fuck yourself. Thanks, come again, or don't. Anyway, again, as I was trying to say, please get the light on. There are a lot of games that have these kind of expansive maps for you to explore here. Map, you know, quote unquote. But the problem with them is that they've designed it in a way where you don't really have a guiding light. There aren't really any intuitive kind of markers. Like this game, for example, has the lanterns that you can see in the distance. And of course, it has these tracks. And I think the terrain was just mapped out in a way that leads you where you need to go. And that's incredibly important for games like this, because if you don't do that right, then the player will end up spending all of their time wandering around aimlessly just trying to figure out where to go. And that can kill the immersion. So I think that they're doing a really good job with the way that they've outlined this. I mean, I want to explore, but I also don't want to leave the track because the track makes me feel whole. All right, I'm gonna keep going here. Just run. Oh, light. I see more light. Let's go. Let's go towards the light. Let's go here. All right. Go towards the light. All right. Oh, okay. It's the house. So you know what? Oh, it's a lantern. Oh, wait. So can I light this one? Can I eat to interact? No? All right, let's go to the house. But you know what? Let's go in the dark. I'm just gonna creep. Like TLC. I'm just creeping on the down low. All right, here we go. Yeah, what is this? What is this here? Let's look at that. Uh-huh. All right, nice. Cute. It's like a Gumby horse. Hi, anybody in there? Anybody in there? Okay. What is this? Okay, mother murders son, blames it on music box. Sounds reasonable. Newly found trails of Andreas, possessions found in river. Okay. Runes found. Wait a minute. Is that? No, that probably doesn't have anything to do with me. Runes Svensson, Henrik. I can't speak. Let's get in here. Can we? Whoop! Alrighty, here we go. Hi, knock knock. Oh. Alright, there's actually somebody in there. I heard coughing. Look at the. What? Why are my arms like. My arms are all bulked up like Popeye. Why is that? Is that what this infection's doing to me? I was infected with spinach. What is this? What is this here? Yeah, that looks like something I could jam in something. I can't see. My big head is in the way. Oh, okay, great. All right, looks like there's a person to the south, a chicken to the east, some kids holding hands on a globe. I don't know. I made that up. But what is over here? Okay, whoever that is snoring up a storm in there. That actually is comforting a little bit. Which is not something I thought I would ever say about snores. Sacrificial rituals of the old days. Good to know that people are keeping up with what's important. Most popular travel locations for a spontaneous trip? Not here. That is the summary of that. And then there's a... Yeah, I already looked at you. All right. What is this? Mushroom cap. Okay. Yeah, so, you know, and to be expected, it's just a piece of shit place. There's a child. All right, so, you know, it seems like everything's in order. Everything is sufficiently creepy. What the fuck? What's, hello? Hello? What's going, holy shit! Okay. Should I... Why am I going in there after hearing that? Is it still in here? Did I come too soon? That's what he said. Okay, get a light going. What the fuck's going on in here? Is that a fucking leg? All right. Okay. All right, you know what? Fine, that's fine. What the... in case I wasn't sure what went on in here from seeing this severed foot, the body was presented to me in kind. Thank you. Ooh. Oh, that's nice. That's actually kind of cool because, all right, I'm going to leave that out for now. Because it's storming here. So that's kind of awesome because it's storming here. And it's like the storm and thunder's raging behind me in the real world, but it's also raging here. Nice. All right. Get a light going. I thought for a second I would be brave and just kind of go through this in the darkness, but then that changed. I changed my mind. All right, let's go. Ooh! Oh, I like that. All right, let's go. I don't have a track anymore, but you see what I'm talking about the layout? Like, even though I don't have a track, you can... Uh-oh. Okay, lights out. Curfew. Where is that happening? Where was that screaming? Ooh, all right. Okay, never mind. All right, light it up. I thought I was going to come across him eating somebody else. But yeah, you know, the way that this is mapped out, I can still go forward. I can still find my way. I love that effect, though. That's really awesome. This game is so beautifully made. Let me see. Look at me with a match that still works in the rain. I'm impressed. I'm impressed with my magic. Oh shit. All right, I spoke too soon. Can you try again? Oh, fuck. Okay. All right, I'm pretty sure I heard footsteps that were not mine because I was not pushing W, but we're just gonna go and we're just gonna keep trying to light this shit. No. I fucking stopped walking. Wait a minute. Let me see if that shit happens again. Because I was not moving and I'm hearing something behind me and I swear to God, if that lightning go... What? No, okay. Nope. I knew it. Go, bitch. Go. No, I don't even want to know. I'm not going to turn. I'm not going to go. Just follow the light. Follow the trails. Just run, bitch. Run like your life depends on it because it probably does. What the fuck is that? What are you? You're fucking... What the... Okay. Oh, shit. Oh. Okay, is that... Oh. It's gone. Oh, wait. Whoa. Is that it? Oh! Okay! All right! So, yeah. Oh, I like this. Oh, I like this a lot. Do I go? Oh, ooh, this is cool. I like that. I really like that art style. Wow. All right. Made... by these people here, everyone who supported, yeah, okay. Guys, kudos to you. Wow, all right, so this is Unforgiving, A Northern Hem. And wow, did I like that. I really did. As you can see in the lower screen here, this game is still in alpha. But anyway, let me do my usual wrap up here. I've said this before, and I said it even when I started this, that a lot of these indie horror games I just don't like. I feel like they miss the mark. And a lot of the areas where other games drop the ball, I think that they're doing really well here. So just to quickly recap some of the things I already mentioned, I think that the layout of their level, so to speak, just of the environment, the way everything is mapped out, and the little bit of cues that they give you so that you can stay on course. I mean, you can veer off course if you want, and that's fine, but just so that you do have a way of staying kind of on pacing and on story, I do like that they have that. I think that they have a really good eye for that. You know, I feel that in games in general, pacing is very important, but in a horror game especially that's meant to be immersive and very atmospheric, it can go from being scary to being tedious really, really quickly. So pacing is especially important in a horror game. And I think that the developers here have a really good head for it. They utilize the mechanics of the game very well to that end. They utilize sound, they utilize environment, scripted events as well, to the player's advantage and to the game's advantage, so that you weren't just, again, wandering around and losing interest in the environment and what you were seeing. That said, I do want to caution them about scripted events and the timing as far as what triggers those events. Because, you know, this can be just a creative choice, but understanding how you want the game to play out for everyone is really important. Do you want everyone to have the same or a similar experience? Or do you want to script the events so that some players may actually see certain things that other players don't see simply because of the way that they were playing? So, for example, when I got to the house and I went inside, you know, you hear the guy in there and he's coughing. And then the monster starts attacking, and you hear that, and you can go up to the door, and you get knocked back. Now, if I choose to edit this out, you're not going to see it, so you're not going to know, so I'm just going to tell you now that when I got into the house, the game actually crashed, and I had to restart and go back to that part. And while I was looking around at the sink, I actually had my sound turned down a little bit. So I wasn't fully aware of what was going on in the room. And the guy was basically just getting destroyed while I was just like, look at this pot. You know, like I just was completely like oblivious. So that when I actually went to the door, I didn't get knocked back that first time. And when I went inside, the body and everything was already there. So that was a completely different experience than when I loaded up the game, you know, after it crashed there. And went back to it this time, and then I could actually hear that something was going on. So I tried the door immediately. And experiencing it the second way was obviously a lot better. And the only difference between the two was the pacing. So for that, I would have had that be an event that's scripted for when I actually go to try the door. You know, once I try the door, then it should trigger the event where now you start hearing the guy scuffling around and you start hearing him scream. Because that way I feel like it would better guarantee that everyone is going to be able to share in that experience, which was pretty integral there. I thought it was a really good scare. And I don't want players to miss out on that kind of moment because of the way that they're playing, you know, but then again, that's a creative choice. Like I said, you may want people to experience games differently. And hey, if that means that there may be something really cool that they don't see, well then, you know, tough tits. It was their fault for kind of wandering around and looking at things instead of just following the path. I just feel like in some cases that may not be the best way to go about it. And you may want to set up the game in a way where, yes, there are some things that are going to be unique to your chosen, you know, style of gameplay, but there will also be a lot of major, really atmospheric things that are scripted in a way to ensure that everybody gets to experience that so that nobody feels like, well, shit, you know, my gameplay was garbage because I didn't see that or that didn't happen to me. You know, I don't want to see people come away from this game with that kind of experience. So that's really the only criticism or opinion or feedback that I would give. I thought the lightning and the rain was a good mechanic, going from having to be dependent upon the matches to now being dependent upon the lightning, which is frightening. And the footsteps as well. That was really good at the end where I was just walking and I stopped moving on the keyboard and I still heard footsteps. Again, with the pacing, you did a very good job of saying, you know what? In case there's somebody who is not listening and they're not picking up on the fact that something is behind them, let's let the music punch in. Let's let the music swell. That's going to make them run. And then, of course, then the troll creaturey thing started growling and I was like, go, bitch. But anyway, that was really good. And I do like the fact that there is folklore here. I don't know if it's actual Swedish like folklore, if these are actual creatures, or if this is just Swedish inspired and the folklore of this is just going to be something that you came up with. But I'm really into that. I'm really into horror games that take that fantasy approach because there are not a lot of them. You know, most of these indie horror games are doing the same shit over and over again. It's all like, I woke up in a hospital, or I woke up in a dirty old house, you know? But to have something where it has this little touch of folklore to it, that's something that always intrigues me about a game. So I like that you chose to do that. And as a matter of fact, because of that, I just want to click into stories. Because I want to highlight this. I want to highlight the monsters that are in here, because I saw this actually before I started capturing when I went into the menu, just to see what everything did. And I thought this was really neat to have this artwork here, and that actually shows some of the creatures that, just from having played the game now, I see are creatures that you're likely to actually encounter in the game. So this bitch right here is the one that bit me. I can tell from her juicy booty that I saw wobbling away from me into the night. And then also whatever that is going on her back. I don't know what that's about. This is, I'm assuming, whatever I saw that scared the troll thing away, that was sitting there playing the violin. So there was that. And yeah, okay. So it looks like this is the thing that was following me. This we did not encounter in the game unless it was here and I didn't see it. So I'm going to guess that this is going to actually be in the full game. All right, some kind of soul sucker. Again, I didn't see that. So I'm going to figure it's going to be in the game. Though there was something, I'm going to tell you, I don't know if you could see it, but there was a part in that mine when I was walking and I thought I saw a fucking shadow. And I thought it was my shadow, but it was moving like in an opposing direction. And I was like, shadows don't do that. I know light. I know what light do. So maybe that was that. I don't know. And this one here, this one really intrigues me because it says, beware of the light that creeps in the night, that gleams in the mist and the gloom. It'll twist truth and lies. You can't trust your own eyes, by your own hand brought to your doom. Seeing this and now reading this, I'm immediately thinking that because we have those lanterns in the game, that we basically trust to be sort of a safe haven, a safe spot, a beacon of hope and security in the night that we can run to. If this is a creature that is somehow either going to mimic the lantern in some way, so like you're like, oh my God, it's dark, and oh wait, there's a lantern, yeah, I'm safe, and you run up to it, and it's this thing? That will be fucking awesome. Like, that will be an awesome mechanic to have in the game, because that's another really specific design choice in a horror game that I don't see a lot of horror games do. I did see Resident Evil 7 do it, actually, and they did it in a very mild way, but there was a part where the character Lucas had rigged these supply crates, you know, with bombs. So this thing that you were trusting originally in the game and throughout the game to be able to smash and get ammo so that you could survive now became something that could actually harm you. And that is a brilliant mechanic. That is an absolutely brilliant mechanic that I don't think enough developers take advantage of. So I'm hoping that that is what the developers are doing here, that they are going to turn your beacon of hope and survival on its head and make it something that could potentially be a threat as well. Yeah, overall, I think they did a really good job with this. They did a really good job. And I'm incredibly picky. So kudos to the developers for making this. I really want to see where this goes. Please, everybody, go play it. Give the developers your feedback, back them, give them your support, because I want to see this game polished. I want to see it fully fleshed out, because I will definitely be getting it. I will definitely be playing it.